Hi, I'm Dr. Nadita Palshetkar.
And I'm Dr. Rohan Palshetkar.
I'm the medical director at 9 Bloom IVF centers all over the country, practicing in Mumbai at the Leelavati Hospital and Palshetkar Patil Nursing Home in Opera House, Delhi, Mohali, Nashik and Navi Mumbai. I've been the past president of FOXI and MOGS and the IAG. I'm the president-elect of ISAR and the current president of the Association of Maharashtra OBGY Societies.
I'm Dr. Rohan Palshetkar. I'm an obstetrician, gynecologist, IVF specialist and endoscopic surgeon practicing in Mumbai and Navi Mumbai. I'm the head of unit at the Bloom IVF Center, D.Y. Patil Nehrul and at Palshetkar Patil Nursing Home at Opera House. I'm currently a managing council member of the Mumbai OBGY Gynac Society. I'm the joint treasurer of the Maharashtra chapter of Indian Association of Gynec Endoscopists. I'm a managing committee member of the Maharashtra chapter of ISAR, and I am the joint secretary of the Association of Maharashtra OBGY Societies. Today, my mother and I are going to be talking about how to cook a perfect shakshuka. First thing what we're going to do is we're going to just put some olive oil, drizzle the pan a little. The olive oil is dependent basically on how much you want to use it. Let it just coat the pan nicely so that you get a nice flavor of the olive oil. You can already see the heat is on high. So first thing what we need to do is reduce the heat a little so that it doesn't really heat up too much. What we're going to do is first put in the garlic so that we get a nice flavorful of garlic with the pan.
Yeah.
Yes, my mother is trying to stir it for me, but I'm a bit of a control freak. So we're gonna just stir it a little. Sometimes you just need to take it off the pan because the heat may be a bit too much, and let it cook on its own. Just leave it be for about a minute or two, and I think you will get a wonderful aroma of the garlic cooking in the olive oil itself. As the garlic is cooking, just keep putting it on and off the heat so that it doesn't burn too much. You can see the garlic is browning up a little. If you can see over here, it's beginning to brown. Just before it browns, we want to start adding the onion to it. Because onion and garlic is going to take a little bit of time to cook before it can actually add the other ingredients.
Brown the onion
a little bit, not too much, because our carrots, bell peppers also need to be cooked a little so that we can get a nice flavorsome meal which is not too raw. Now what we're going to do is, now that we can see that the onions are browning and the garlic is also cooked, we're going to start adding our salami and sausages. Basically, this is when all the entire mixture comes into play. We're going to start adding the bell peppers, the carrots. Carrots is up to you. I like a little bit of carrots in my dish, and the mushrooms. Put it back on. Let them all cook, mix up a little nicely.
Do you need to put a cover?
And later, once we put the eggs and the sauce. The gas, I feel, is still a little too high, so I want to reduce the flame to its minimum. There, I got it to a nice low flame. I'm stirring it, but it depends on how much you want it cooked. It depends on each person how much oil. I feel that the sausage and the salami gives out enough oil, to cook the dish itself. And plus now we're going to be adding the sweet chili sauce. Be generous when you're putting the sauce, because that's what it's eventually going to cook in. So basically now what we're doing is we're going to stir so that the sweet chili sauce simmers in everything.
Oh, it looks good.
Yeah.
Just eat it by itself.
You can actually. If you just
leave vegetarian.
It. For the vegetarian bit, you just avoid the chicken and the salami. You can just keep vegetables, add the sauce. Obviously, you have to be an egg eater for a shakshuka because the egg is the integral part of it. Now it all depends on how many eggs also you want to put. Generally, I put in about only one egg for so much. But if you're serving this, this can be eaten easily by about 2 to 3 people. So if each person wants their yolk, you can easily have it. So basically we're going to put it like a half fry.
Oh.
Just let it roll on.
Oh, that's it?
That's it.
You don't mix it?
Nope. We leave it, we let the egg cook. Just make sure the albumin of the egg spreads. The yolk has ruptured, but it's okay.
So it's not supposed to rupture?
Ideally, you shouldn't have it ruptured. But if it is, then another alternative, which is a good time
to show now.
Is we could mix it or we just leave it like this. And we just let it simmer for some time. While it's simmering, you can try and toast your bread, or you can just get some other ingredients what you want to have with it, either a roti or even rice if you like.
It's very easy to make.
Very simple.
Even a non-cook like me can do it.
A non-cook like me can do it, so why not? Yeah. So we're just going to let it simmer for about 2 to 3 minutes, and then once it cooks up, we should be ready to eat.
But are your vegetables cooked?
Yeah, so, one thing you should know, all the vegetables were cooked a little prior. The carrots have already been cooked before. The mushrooms have been cooked before. The bell peppers is more for a texture basis rather than for the cooking purpose. Because everything will be soft and gooey otherwise. The bell peppers, if you put it in raw, give you a slightly better texture to the food.
Okay.
So let's just wait till it cooks.
Really good. Salt and pepper afterwards?
Yeah. So then on top for seasoning, what you do is just add a pinch of salt. Salt is basically according to taste. Okay. Because the sausage, the salami and all of the the sauce will already have enough salt in it to give flavor. And again, pepper according to taste. It's more like a topping, like an oregano, rather than this. Now it depends on how thick you want your gravy. You can just let it cook for a little time more if you want it a little
more. This is good.
But if you like it a little bit of a flavored gravy style, then I think you can just take it out of the pan. What you can do is just immediately keep this pan on a nice hot stove and leave it as it is, and it's ready to serve as like that. You could garnish it with a little bit of coriander if you like, but I like to serve it as it is. Of course, the yolk is melted, but if you have 2-3 yolks, the yolks would be sitting on top in a beautiful fashion, ready to eat.
So I'm going to now have my shakshuka. So friends, let me know when you make it and tell us how it tastes.
All right, enjoy. Bon appetit.